Good evening and welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the 10th annual Conrad Weiser Hits for Hope draw ceremony. Very excited to be with you here. I am tournament director Ryan Knarr, and we are back after a full year hiatus in 2020 due to the COVID-19 pandemic. With me here tonight in our studio is our head tournament referee, Mr. Ralph Tunling. He's been here for all 9 events, and he's back for year number 10 here in 2021.
Hello.
Also here tonight for our Hits for Hope draw ceremony, we'd love to involve the kids in our draw ceremony here as we pick the different draws for the 2021 Hits for Hope tennis tournament. We have two of our young CWTA players, Mr. Gio Garcia and Juliet Perkins. We are really excited to be here tonight. We are going to be going through all 36 draws of the Conrad Weiser Hits for Hope tennis tournament, picking 3 of them live right here for you tonight, and then also showing the other 33 draws that were predetermined through the TDM software, through the computer program after the seeds were inputted randomly. So we're excited to get that here tonight. Our 2021 Hits for Hope Tennis Tournament, the 10th anniversary, it benefits a different charity every year. And this year is no different. We will be actually utilizing 9 charities this year that we're going to be donating to. And those are the 9 charities that we have had for the first 9 years of the tournament. We started out year 1 and we had the American Cancer Society. Year 2 was the American Lung Association. From there, in year 3, we went to the Gift of Life, followed by the American Heart Association. The next one was the American Foundation for Suicide Prevention. From there, we also did the Global Colon Cancer Association, the YMCA of Reading and Berks County. And the last 2 years, we had the Love All Knarr Family Foundation and the Jimmy V. Foundation for Cancer Research. So those are the 9 charities. The great thing about it here for our tournament going on June 14th and the 20th is you get to pick where your entry fee goes to, and that will allow you to pick one of those 9 charities. Many of you have done so already within the online signup on hitsforhope.com. And for those of you who have done a manual signup, you'll get to do that upon your registration. Just a few things before we get started here that we want to highlight for the tournament this year. Number 1 is the dates. And again, we're going to be going through this. You will be getting a lot of emails going back and forth for when things start, so on and so forth. We really, with an event this size, make sure that communication is key. Our 10 and under tournament kicks things off at 6 o'clock on Monday, June 14th. Right here at Conrad Weiser Tennis Facility, and then we move into the main portion of the junior tournament, which is on Tuesday, June 15th. 12 and under, 14 and under, 18 and under, the singles, the doubles, the mixed. And then we also move into that night our coach player draws, which are a fun 10-point tiebreaker event on Tuesday night. Wednesday, more junior tennis all day long. We also have our family draws that get started, mother, son, mother, daughter, father, father, daughter, brother, brother, all those draws, and those will be fast 4 sets, 2 out of 3 sets, played Wednesday and Thursday night. Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, our adult tournament rolls into town, and we have all the adult draws that will be taking place at that time. The other part of the tournament that is always special is our Night of Champions, and we invite everybody to come out for that, whether you're a player, a participant, a fan, somebody involved with the charities, somebody involved with Berks County Tennis, and that is our Berks County Tennis Night of Champions, which is Saturday, June 19th at 7:30 in the evening here at Conrad Weiser Tennis Facility. Always a great night for the tennis community to come together and to continue to play for something bigger than just yourself. So with that, Ralph, if we're ready to get started here, we will get rolling here. Just a reminder, there are 3 sites that you will we'll be playing at here. Conrad Weiser Tennis Facility here on the campus of Conrad Weiser School District is our main site. All players, whether you're playing at that site or the other 2 sites, must do your registration and check-in, tournament check-in, whether you've registered online previously or manually, you must come to this site, sign the waiver, get your tournament player bag, and then you can go to, if you're playing at one of the other two sites for your first matches, go to those sites for the start of your play. Conrad Weiser Tennis Facility is the main site here, five courts with lights. Our secondary site is Telpahockin High School, that has six courts. And then our third site is Elko High School, and that has five lit courts. On the draw, when you see it, it will have next to your spot in the draw for all of your draws, a CW for Conrad Weiser, Telpy for Telpahockin, or Elko for Elko, and that is where you are playing. But again, a reminder, before your first match of the tournament, if you're playing at one of the secondary or third sites, you must come here first to check in, sign the waiver, get your player bag, and then you can go to that site. These draws that we're going to show here tonight and pick here tonight, they will also be up on the website once we get everything scheduled. So we're going to get these things scheduled, and hopefully by this weekend, Saturday, Sunday, everything will be up there with your start times under the button that says Tournament Draws. It will be on there as a PDF. Please make sure, just a reminder, that you're going through all of your draws and making sure you're getting all of your start times. Okay? Last thing before we get started, we want to do a special thanks to all of our sponsors. Our sponsors have been from day one, year one, the last 10 years, unbelievably supportive of this event as the largest tennis tournament in Pennsylvania. And again, what we've like to deem a festival of tennis for this entire region and the whole state coming together to play for something bigger than just yourself. So with that, we're going to get started here. We'll get our draws going. If you guys want to have a seat, we'll get a couple draws that we've already had computer generated up first. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to go through each of the seeds. So I will go through starting with some of our junior draws with the seeds, and then Ralph will show the draw behind me, and we will go through line by line the first round matchups, who's playing who, so you can see that live here on the Hits for Hope tournament draw ceremony. All right, Ralph, we're ready to go here. We're going to start with boys 18 singles. And boys 18 singles is a big draw. We have 44 players in this. Very big draw. Very excited to have that many players in the tournament here for that draw. So we have, I believe, 14 seeds. And we'll go through it, our top seed. And how are these done? Our big draws, our boys 18 singles, girls 18 singles. All of these we've utilized an all factors method based on the platform of also using UTR, Universal Tennis Rating, to give us the opportunity. That rating in past years has given us about a 96% accuracy in returns of results of the tournament with seeds holding and whatnot. And this year, again, we are utilizing UTR as our main source for seeding. So, our boys 18 singles, our seeds to get things started are, I'll grab a quick piece of paper here.
You want me to read them off?
We have, I'll go through it, Ralph. Our top seed is from over in Lancaster, Cooper Lehman, 2 seed from out in also the central part of the state, Mr. William Ong, the 3 seed, Alex Guy, 4 seed, Jack Nevolt, 5 seed is Charlie Robbins, the 6 seed is the Berks County singles champion, Zachary Schrader, 7 seed, Teddy Snyder, 8 seed, Viraj Patel, the 9 seed from Twin Valley High School, Jackson Bonds, the 10 seed from E-Town, Trent McBride, the 11 seed from up in Allentown, Josh Thomas, and the 12 seed, Ethan Moyer. Ralph, our 13 and 14 seeds, do you have those? We have a 13 and a 14 seed. Okay, so they're on there. Seeding 14 players. Yes, we'll see them as we go through the list. So with that, we're going to look here at the top of the bracket again. Cooper Lehman, your top seed on line 3. We have the guy in the house here tonight, Gio Garcia. He'll be taking on Truman Peters from Wyomissing. Okay. On line number 5, Michael Schutz from Berks Catholic High School, the recent graduate. He'll be taking on the winner of Jason Kaufman or Alice Avram from Berks Catholic. Making our way down Here on line number 9, we have the 9 seed Jackson Bonds from Honeybrook, and he'll get a bye. And in the second round, he'll be playing Alex Waltz or Trent Myers from Mannheim. If we look down here on line 13, we have the 8 seed Viraj Patel, and he will also get a bye, and he'll be playing the winner of Austin Rutherford and Armand Malik, the incoming freshman here at Conrad Weiser, with the winner to get Patel. Next up is the 5 seed here, Charlie Robbins, on line 17, our 5 seed, and he'll get the winner of Marquez Amboski and from York PA, Jaden Vu. And our 12 seed is Ethan Moyer, and he will get a bye. He'll get the winner of Colin Clayball and Brendan Guy from York PA. Now we make our way down here. There's our 13 seed, Rocco Ciccarelli from Lebanon, and he will get in the first round. He will be getting Fox Bryan, the number 1 player from Conrad Weiser. And down into the bottom half here, as we make our way into the bottom of the top half, we have Jack Nivelle, and he's from the Elizabethtown area, and he'll be taking on the winner of Jaden Lewis and Clayton Hickey from Moton. Now we're in the bottom half of the boys' 18 singles draw. We have Blake Nolte from Kutztown. He'll be taking on Reed Kopsik from Burnville, with the winner to get Alex Guy from York, PA. Line 37, another Kutztown player, Otis Angle. He'll be taking on Austin Kohler from Sinking Spring, with the winner to get our 14 seed, Tony Giragelli. Okay? And again, please excuse the pronunciation. I'm trying our best here. We have a ton of players. On the line number 41, Chris Chan from Berks Catholic. He will take on the wide receiver number 1, Jay Schreck, with the winner to get the 11 seed, Joshua Thomas from Allentown. On line 45, we have the number 1 player from Brandywine Heights, Nathan Berger, and he'll be taking on Xander Heidel, with the winner to get the Berks County Singles Champion from 2021, Zachary Schrader, as the 6th seed. Making their way down to the bottom quarter, we have Dylan Bonds, Jackson's younger brother, and he'll be playing Pratik Kunduru from Exeter, with the winner to get the number 1 player at Exeter, Teddy Snyder, who is the 7th seed. On line 53, we have Aaron Pearson. He has a bye, and he'll be playing Trent McBride from Elizabethtown. And Eric Yazimowski, the 2nd, the younger brother of the Yazimowski brothers, he'll be playing Danny Mitchell, the number 1 player from Governor Mifflin, with the winner to get Gerardo Sanchez from Reading. And finally, all the way at the bottom, we have Carter Oland taking on John Thorpe in an all-wiser matchup, with the winner to get our 2 seed from Mechanicsburg, Will Ahn. So that, Ralph, wraps up our boys' 18 singles. It is a deep draw, a lot of great players from all over the center part, eastern part of Pennsylvania. With that, Ralph, we'll go over to the girls' 18 singles draw. Now, our girls' 18 singles draw is exactly, to a T, 16 players. Okay, we had 16 players, 4 seeds. Our top 4 seeds for the girls' 18 singles here. Our top seed, the PIAA State Doubles Champion, Emma Perkins. The 2 seed from Hempfield, Grace Lehman. The 3 seed from Exeter, Anya Whitman. And the 4 seed, the number 1 player at Reading High, Ashley Ratana. If we look at the draw here behind us, we have Emma Perkins taking on Anika Suresh from Collegeville in the first round. Lydia Bayshore taking on Seishri Luparju. Ashley Ratana taking on Sierra Smart from Kutztown, PA. Catherine Masano taking on Michelle Timothy. Isabel Wiggins taking on Haley Guerrero from Reading. Lauren Clymer taking on Anya Whitman, the 3 seed. Haley Guerrero taking on Victoria Waltz. And Hansika Kunduru taking on the 2 seed, Grace Lehman from Hempfield. And again, a 16 draw for the girls' 18 singles here at the Hits for Hope Tennis Tournament 2021. Okay, Ralph, we will then move to our boys' 18s doubles. We'll be getting into the doubles draws here. So we'll go two more draws, and then we're going to have our first picked draw here tonight. I know these guys are anxiously awaiting the opportunity to do that. Okay, boys 18s doubles. We have 16 teams. That will give us four seeds. And the four seeds are Cooper Lehman and Charlie Robbins as the top seed, the two seed McBride and Nevite from out in Elizabethtown area. We have the three seed of Alex Guy and Joshua Thomas, and the four seed Rocco Ciccarelli and Garrett Marica from over in Lebanon County. So there are your four seeded teams. If we look here behind us, the team of Lehman and Robbins, they'll be taking on in the first round Clayball and Kopsik in the round of 16. Excuse me, that's the round of 32. We have Xander Heidel and John Thorpe taking on the Bonds brothers on lines 5 and 7. Line 9, we have the 4-seed, Marika and Ciccarelli. They'll be taking on Holland and Pearson. On line 13, we have the Berks County doubles champions, Alex Waltz and Janie Lewis from Conrad Weiser. They have the bye, and they will be playing the winner of Alex Abram and Chris Chan from Berks Catholic versus the gentleman here to my right, Gio Garcia and Armand Malik, with the winner getting Waltz and Lewis. On line 17 and 18, we have Fox Bryan and Ethan Moyer taking on Brendan Guy and Jaden Vu. And they will be meeting in the round of 16. We have the Yazimbowski brothers on line 22, Mark and Eric Yazimbowski taking on Alex Guy and Joshua Thomas for three seats. All the way down into the bottom quarter, we have Gerardo Sanchez and Zachary Schrader, the team out of Reading High, taking on Tony Giardelli, and again, his partner had just pulled out right before here of the draw ceremony, so he is getting another partner. We will update that as soon as we get his partner, the name of his partner there on line number 28. Finally, we go to Sangel and Blake Nolte from Kutztown, and they'll be taking on the two seeds, Trent McBride and Jack Navit from the Elizabethtown area. So Ralph, that takes care of boys 18s doubles. Let's go ahead right over to girls 18s doubles. And we have 9 teams here in girls 18s doubles. That will give us two seeds. And the two seeds are Emma Perkins and Michelle Timothy as the one seed. The two seed, Ashley Ratana and Haley Guerrero from Reading High. If we look at the draw here behind us, Perkins and Timothy get Clymer and Smart in the quarterfinals. Waltz and Wiggins from Weiser, they will get Haley Guerrero and Valeria Sanchez from Reading High. We have Station Parju and Hansika Konduru taking on Lydia Bayshore and Catherine Masano. We have one pigtail in there. We have Bryn Leffler and Reagan Wenrick, and they will be taking on Emily McGonigal and Gracie McMahon, with the winners to get Ratana and Guerrero as the two seeds. So that takes care of our boys singles, our girls singles, our boys 18s doubles, and our girls 18s doubles as well. That will bring us now to the mixed doubles, Ralph, and this is going to be our first draw that will be picked here tonight. And we will have Juliet and Gio, if you guys want to come up here. You can come up here and stand right here. And I will, one of you can hold the cup. So Gio, come right next to me right here, buddy. Very good. Juliet will pick, and she will tell the camera then what the teams are. Give us 1 minute. We've got to announce the seeds first. You ready to go, Ralph? Excellent. Okay. So our mixed 18s doubles. We have over 20 teams in this draw. It is a pretty deep field. A lot of these players also playing singles and doubles. We will seed 4 teams here for the mixed 18 doubles. The top seed are the sister and brother pairing from over at Hempfield, Cooper and Grace Lehman. Our 2 seed, Emma Perkins and Charlie Robbins. The 3 seed is Zachary Schrader and Haley Guerrero, and the 4 seed, Teddy Snyder and Anya Whitman. Okay, we're gonna start here at the top. Now, how this works, Juliet will pick one of the names out of here. She will read it aloud, and we'll make sure we mix it up nice and Go here, she will read aloud the team, and they will start and be placed right on line number three. So essentially, they will play the top seed in the first round. Are we ready, guys? Okay. Gio, mix those up in there. Put your hand in there, mix them up nice and, there you go. Good. Okay, Juliet, go ahead and pick one. Who do we have? Okay, you just picked, so it will be Gio, Garcia, and Hansika Kunduru, and they will be playing on line number three. They will be playing Lehman and Lehman in the first round. Okay, next line, you will pick on line number five here. Go ahead.
Pearson and Mason?
Yes. Yep, Aaron Pearson and Catherine Masana. Okay, so we'll have Masano and Pearson, and they will be on line number five. How about line number seven? Go ahead, Juliet, one more here.
Heidel and Leffler.
Okay, Xander Heidel and Bryn Leffler, they will be on line number seven. Okay, we're in the bottom half of the draw. How about Juliet, how about you take the cup now, we'll let Gio pick. All right, Gio, here we go, buddy. This is for line number 11 to play against the Snyder and Whitman seeded team.
Kopsik and McGonigal.
Okay, Reed Kopsik and Emily McGonigal. They will be on line number 11, and they will get the seeded team of Teddy Snyder and Anya Whitman. Okay, next we're going to be on line 15, and this is a pigtail match to play into the Brian and Ritanya team that is seeded fifth. We actually do have six seeds here. Brian and Ritanya are the five seed, and Lewis and Timothy are the six seed. Okay, go ahead, Gio.
Mupgarju and Kaladini.
Kaladini, Arian Kaladini, and Seshri Muparaju. So they will go on line number 15. And then into line number 16. Yep, keep stirring those up, Juliet. Go ahead, Gio.
Emily
Zimbowski
and Bayshore.
Marquez Zimbowski and Lydia Bayshore will be on line 16, and they will be taking on Caladini and Luparju. Okay, down to the next part, line 17 and 18. This is the Lewis Timothy seeded team. This is on line 20 to play them in the first round.
Engel and Smart.
Otis Engel and Sierra Smart. They will get the team of Lewis and Timothy. Okay, line 21, Gio.
You and Steele.
Okay, we have the team out of York of Jaden Vu and I believe it is Alyssa or Allison Steele. Correct me if I'm wrong, but they will be playing on line number 21. Okay, that's the VU, VU, or Steel. Just waiting for Ralph here.
There it is.
There they are. Okay, next, this is line 22. Go ahead, Gio.
Sanchez and Sanchez.
Okay, Valeria and Gerardo Sanchez. They will be on line 22. And that will be playing right into the Guerrero Schrader seed, third seed on line 24. Okay, this is line 25 and 26. Go ahead, Gio.
Yuzendowski and Jay Perkins.
All right. Juliet and the lady next to you and Eric Yuzendowski. They will be on line 25 to play them. Right there, yeah.
Where?
Right under the two seed. You just missed them. Go back down a little bit. Ralph. Keep going, right there. Yep. Okay, that's line 25. This is line 26. Pick a good one, Gio.
Altland and V. Waltz.
Okay, Victoria Waltz and Carter Altland will be taking on Juliet Perkins and Eric Yazembowski.
Where is it?
Okay.
I can't find it. Waltz and Wiggins?
Nope, all the way up. Keep going. There we go, first one.
This one?
Yep. Okay, line 28. This is a bye, so this will play into that pigtail match. Go ahead, Gio.
Alex Lox and Emma Wiggins.
Okay, Alex Waltz and Isabel Wiggins. So we have two Waltzes in the same quarter there. That'll be line 28. And finally, the last one, Gio. This is on line 30 to play Emma Perkins and Charlie Robbins. Okay, Colin Claybaugh and Gracie McMahon will get Perkins and Robbins in the first round. All right, well, thank you very much, guys. We will see these two in a second. We're going to continue with the picking here in a couple draws, but we're going to go back to our computer-generated draw. So if you guys want to have a seat, and we will get back to our computer-generated draws. Okay, so that was our 18s mixed doubles. Now, we're going to be getting into one of the bigger draws here, and this is our men's singles draw. We have over 43 players here for men's singles, okay? That includes 14 seeds for this draw. And I'm going to go through these again, generated by UTR. And the 14 seeds are our 14th seed from Muncie, PA, F. Taylor Clark. Our 13th seed, Elliot Kleckner. Our 12th seed, Alex Guy. Our 11th seed, Will Ong. Our 10th seed, Christian Siafi. The 9th seed from Westchester, former Weiser graduate, Nicholas Palasi. The 8th seed from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, Lee Wexler. The 7th seed, a defending Hits for Hope singles champion, originally from Trucksville, now lives in the Harrisburg area, Mr. Eric Frigis. Our 6th seed from Langhorne, Corey Garnier. The 5th seed, Eric Tamaru. And again, please excuse my pronunciation. The 4th seed from St. Francis University, Matt Blose. The 3 seed, the recent Pequay Valley graduate going to Washington College, Brady Burns. The 2 seed, Dan Trefoy. And our number 1 seed, the 4-time Hits for Hope singles champion, Mr. Andre Fick. So again, it's Fick, Trefoy, Burns, and Blose as the top 4 seeds. We have 14 seeds here. And again, due to time, we had this draw computer generated prior to the live taping of the draw ceremony. So Ralph, we'll just go through this at the top. Obviously we have Fick up on line 1. On line number 3, we have the coach of Penn State Abington, Eric Gibson, and he'll be taking on Ethan Moyer, who plays out at Kutztown University. On line number 5, we have Teddy Snyder. He will get the winner of Douglas Taylor and the recent Berks County graduate, Michael Schutz. On line number 9, we encounter Lee Wexler, the 8th seed, and he will play Gerardo Sanchez from Reading, followed by line 13, Nicholas Palasi, the 9th seed, and he will get the winner of Pratik Kunduru and Ethan Rothermel, a former county champion from Brandywine Heights. Okay, line number 17, we have Alex Guy as the 12th seed, and he will be getting Colburn Byler from Reading, PA on line 19. We get down into line 21, and line 21 is Eric Tamaru, and he will be, he is from New Market, Maryland, so out of state, and he will be getting the winner of Fox Bryan and Austin Rutherford. Making our way down to line 25 here, the top half of the men's singles draw for Hits for Hope 2021, we have Nick Weber, the player from Penn State Berks, taking on James McLaughlin from Lancaster, PA. Making our way down, we have Matt Blose from St. Francis College, or St. Francis University, rather, Division I program there. And he will get the winner of Nicholas Perella or Charlie Robbins from Cedar Crest High School. On line 33, we get into Alex Waltz. He will be taking on the number 1 player from Alvernia University, Michael Brophy, with the winner to get the recently graduated player from Pequay Valley, the 3 seed, Brady Burns. On line 38, we have Jacob Hefner from Kutztown, and he will be playing F. Taylor Clark from Muncie, PA. Down to line number 41, we have the number 1 player from Wyomissing this year, Jay Schreck. And he will be playing Steve Kerman from Reading, with the winner to get the 11 seed, William Ahn. Okay, line 45, we have Dr. Dave Jemison. He'll be taking on from Alvernia, Kevin Angelus on line 45 and 46, with the winner to get Corey Garnier on line 48 as the 6th seed. We get down to line 50, we have Matt Borky. He will get the former champion here at Hits for Hope, Eric Frigis, as the 7th seed. And on line 53 and 54, we have Sanchez Buenaventura, and he'll be playing Zachary Schrader there in the first round on line 53 and 54, with the winner getting Christian Siafi from South Williamsport. Making our way down to the bottom of the draw, we have Clayton Hickey taking on Ben Hinckley, kind of a wordplay there. Hickey and Hinckley playing each other. And they will be playing Elliot, the winner against the 13 seed Elliot Kleckner. Finally, on line 61, we have Mark Yasmowski and Jeffrey Bauer from, I believe, LVC. And the winner will be getting Dan Trefoy, the number 2 overall seed here in the first round of the Hits for Hope men's draw. It is a 64 draw, over 40 players in this draw. Again, prize money this year for the men's singles and the women's singles for the first time in tournament history. We're very excited to be able to do prize money here for the men's singles and women's singles. For our women's singles, we have, we want to bring that draw up around. We'll go to women's singles next. It's already, we'll go to women's singles next. We have 11 players in the women's singles draw, actually 12 now. And this one, again, computer generated ahead of time. Can't pick all the draws here on it. We'd have a 3-hour draw ceremony. So we do these computer generated and just pick a few draws. Our women's singles, we have 4 seeds here for the Hits for Hope 2021 prize money women's singles draw. Our number 1 seed from Naples, Florida, by way of St. Joseph's University, Laura Gomez. Our 2 seed, Greta Cuck, the 3 seed, Emma Perkins, and the 4 seed, Alyssa Gleason. If we look at the draw here, Gomez gets a bye in the first round. She will be playing the winner of Michelle Timothy or Seishri Luparju. With the 4 seed on line 5, Alyssa Gleason taking on Hansika Kunduru in the first round. On line 7 and 8, we have Sierra Smart and Julia Tan up there. We have Becca Perkins. And the winner of that will play into the Gleason seeded team on the top half of the draw. Bottom half of the draw, we have from Kutztown, Lauren Clymer, taking on Anika Suresh from Collegeville. And the winner of that will get to play the 3 seed, Emma Perkins. On the bottom half of the draw, last quarter, we have Isabel Wiggins on line 13, taking on from Alvernia University, Laura Coveley, with the winner to get the 2 seed, Greta Cuck. All right, so we've gone through men's singles, we've gone through women's singles. It is now time, Ralph, for men's doubles. Men's doubles. Okay, and we have 5 seeded teams here. I actually don't have this one in front of me, Ralph. I'm just gonna go through the seeds. If you just wanna scan down here, Ralph, and again, these are all to be determined. We will be picking these out of the cup. Gio, if you wanna take this over to Ralph and get those names in the cup over there, we'll get those right there, yeah. And that'll be the men's doubles. All right, so he'll mix those up, and you can stand here, Juliet. You can come right to Gio, right here. Gio, closer this way, so we can get everybody on camera. All right, Ralph, we're going to go through this. Just scan down here, Ralph. We have our top seed from Fredericksburg, Virginia, Ryan Berry and his partner, Nolan Perugini. If we look down at the 2 seeds, we have Corey Garnier and Lee Wexler from the Philly area. There they are, all the way on line 32. If we go up a little bit, we have the 3rd seed from up.
Hold on.
Yep.
There it is.
Yep. Oh, go down a second row. We just have to see the 3C.
There is a 3C.
Yep, oh, there they are. We have Clark and Siafi on line number 9. We have the 4C, which is the team of Velasi and Burns. If we keep going down, there they are. Velasi and Burns as the 4C. The 5C, if we go all the way to the top, Ralph. There they are. Shank, keep going down, keep going down, keep going. There they are, Shankroff and Plettner. And all the way down at the bottom, we have the 6C, Dan Trefoy and Tad Ritter. Okay, are we ready to go, guys? So we have all our C's here, 6-seeded teams, 22 teams. We're gonna start at the top. Gio, if you wanna hold the cup, we'll let Juliet pick. Here we go, line number 3. Okay, we have the team of Thomas and Nevins. I think Ralph is listed under Nevins and Thomas on the actual draw. Okay, this is going to be on line number 4. This will be the pigtail to play into the top seeds. Go ahead, Julia. We have Joe Alessandrini and Mike Pedersen. So Mike Pedersen, or Peterson rather, and Joe Alessandrini, the Twin Valley duo there, and they will be taking on Thomas and Devins. Okay, line number 5. Go ahead, Juliet.
Angeles and
Brophy.
Yep. Kevin Angeles and Mike Brophy, the number 1 team from Alvernia University, and they will be taking on line number 6.
Epler and B. Fitz.
Okay, Brian Fitzpatrick and Taylor Epler. Okay, this is line number 8, Ralph?
7.
We're on 7. Okay, line 7. Go ahead, Juliet, pick another one.
Gibson and Kerbin.
Okay, Steve Kerbin and Eric Gibson. This will be on line number 7. This will be line number 8 now. Okay, Jaden Lewis and Alex Waltz, the Berks County doubles champions on line number 8. Okay.
Hold on. There it is.
There they are. Okay, this is to play the 5 seed now. And you can see, Ralph, that just needs to be switched there on line 9 if you come out, is Shankroff and Kleckner.
What are you talking about?
If you look at right to the right in the random, it's Shankroff and Kleckner. Line 9 just needs to be adjusted. You just need to put them in there.
Shankroff and Kleckner?
Yep, on line number 9.
I'll try.
Okay.
Wait a minute, I can't do it.
Okay, so we'll make it.
Wait, oh, no.
There we go. All right, just make it.
The number
Shankroff and Kleckner, yep.
That's a glitch. That's
yep, there is a glitch there. We will get that one. Oh, there they are. All right, perfect. Excellent. Okay. So, this will be to play into that quarter, line number 11. Go ahead.
Friel and Keaton.
Okay, Jason Friel and his partner Keaton from the Philadelphia area, and they will be playing on line number 12. Go ahead.
That's 9, 11. Now we're doing 12.
Yep. Borky and Lackup, and that team will be playing on line 12. So Friel and Keaton against Borky and Lackup, line 11 and 12. Okay, this is where the 3C is. This is Siafi and Taylor Clark on line number 13. They will get the bye. So this will be to pick, this will be line 15 and 16. Go ahead, Gio.
Yenser.
Okay, J.R. Yenser and Ben Hinckley. That'll be on line 15. And here we go for line number 16. Go ahead, Gio.
Boyer and Rivas Cortez.
Okay, Bailey Boyer and Luis Rivas Cortez. And they will be on line 16, taking on Hinckley and Yenser, with the winner to get Siafi and Clark. All right. Moving down here, as we continue down the draw, line 17 and 18. Another pigtail. This will play into the Ritter and Trefoy quarter of the draw.
Perella and Weber.
Nick Perella and Nick Weber, the Cookstown duo. And this will be on line number 18. Again, the pigtail to play into Trefoy and Ritter.
Yenser and Lapin.
Yep, Lake and Yenser. Lake and Yenser. Okay, very good. Now, we are on line 21 and 22. This is a pigtail.
Wait a minute. What is it? Who is it?
Lake and Yenser.
Oh, Lake.
Yep, L-A-P-E. Lake and Yenser. There we go. All right, down to line 21 and 22, and this will play into the seeded team of Balassi and Berks. Line 21, go ahead, Gio.
Pettis and Jay Fitzpatrick.
Yep, Quincy Pettis and Jack Fitzpatrick. All right, that's line 21. 22. There they are, Pettis and Fitzpatrick. All right, line 22. Go ahead, Gio.
Marielle and
Shakrelli. Yeah, we have Shakrelli and Marika. So Shakrelli and Marika will play Fitzpatrick and Pettis, and that will play into the Burns Velocity sector of the draw. Okay, line 25. Go ahead, Gio.
Baver and Byler.
Okay, Bauer and Byler, the team from LBC. They will be on line 25. Keep going, Gio. Line 26 to play Byler and Bauer.
Heffler and Rothermel.
Yep, we have Jake
and Rothermel.
Heffner and Rothermel. That'll be on line 26. They'll be playing Byler and Bauer. Okay, we have we got one on the ground here. We had one on the ground there. We dropped one. So mix up those three. We have three more to go. Okay, line 28. Gio, go ahead.
Byler and Lammy.
Okay, we have Byler and Lammy. There we go. And they will be on line 28. Okay, the last two here, Gio. This will be in the Garnier and Wexler portion.
Brian and Moyer.
Okay, Fox Brian and Ethan Moyer. And they will be playing on line number 30.
Sanchez and Schrader.
Okay. The team of Zachary Schrader and Gerardo Sanchez on line number 30. So that will be, Fox Brian and Ethan Moyer against Gerardo Sanchez and Zachary Schrader. And they will get the winner of Garnier and Wexler as the two seeds. So that will then take us to through our men's doubles. So we've gone through men's singles, women's singles, men's doubles. You guys can take a break for one draw. You can have a seat. And then we're going to go through next our women's doubles. Okay. Our women's doubles, we have exactly eight teams. And of those eight teams, we are seeding the top two. Our top seed is Alyssa Gleason and Kara Wirth. And our two seed, Emma Perkins and Greta Cook. At the top half of the draw, we have Gleason and Wirth. They're playing Clymer and Smart. We have Coveley and Mayer playing Kunduru and Luparju. We have Julie Seidel, Julie Carmen now, the married name, and Becca Perkins taking on Michelle Timothy and Isabel Wiggins, and Karen Norheim and Ann Tracy taking on Greta Cook and Emma Perkins. Okay, so that takes care of our women's doubles. We're going to go right into our mixed doubles, another big draw. This is our last pick draw that is getting picked here tonight. So Juliet, do you want to take the cup over to Ralph? And we will get these in and we'll bring you guys right back up. Or Gio, if you want to go get those. Okay. And there we go. So we have our mixed doubles draw here. And this draw is 20 teams. 20 teams. And we have four seeded teams here. We have four seeded teams. Our top seed for the mixed open doubles is the team of Andre Fick and Laura Gomez as the one seed. Our two seeds, Kashif Das, only playing mixed doubles and doubles this year, and Emma Perkins, the three seed, Dan and Mara Trefoy, and the four seed, Michelle Timothy and Ethan Moyer. Okay, are we ready to go, guys? We're gonna start at the top, Ralph, and we will come all the way down. This is on line number three to play a pigtail in the Fick Gomez part of the draw. Go ahead. We have Kunduru and Kunduru, Pratik and Hansika Kunduru. And they will get the winner of, or they will play the first round. Go ahead, pick another one. Friel and Tracy. So that will be a first round match between Jason Friel and Ann Tracy against Kunduru. Kunduru with the winner to get Fick and Gomez. Okay, next up.
Climber and Weber.
Okay, Climber and Weber. Lauren Climber and Nick Weber from Kutztown. And they will get on line number seven. They will each receive a bye, so they will be playing in the round of 16.
Scully and Scully.
The Shkreli's. We have the Shkreli's from Lebanon, and they will be on line seven playing Climber and Weber. All right, down to line number 11, and this is into 4C Ethan Moyer and Michelle Timothy. Line number 11. Go ahead, Juliet.
Epler and you.
Okay, Ali Yo and Taylor Epler. They will be on line 11. They will get Ethan Moyer and Michelle Timothy. Okay, line number 13 and 14. Go ahead, Juliet. Oh, Garcinau and Cole, or Garassi rather, Garassi and Cole. That one was a tough one. Garassi and Cole. Okay, this will be on line 14. Go ahead, another one, Juliet. This will be line 14 to play Garassi and Cole.
Perella and Smart.
Okay, Sierra Smart and Nick Perella. Smart and Perella on line 14. Okay, line 15 and 16. This is the bottom part of the top half of the draw. Go ahead.
Fusner and Williams.
Fusner and Williamson. Sebastian Williamson and Sakira Fusner on line 15. And
Fusner.
Yep. And line number 16 to play Fusner and Williamson. We have, and you know that name, right? Becca Perkins and Brian Fitzpatrick. And they will be playing Williamson and Fusner. Okay, let's switch it here. Gio, you want to pick some here? We're gonna switch gears. We'll go to line 18. Gio, go ahead. Your pick for line 18.
Okay. Norheim and Lindbeck.
Okay, Karen Nordheim and John Lindbeck. Okay. That'll be on line number 18, and this will be a bye. This will actually get them to play them straight up in the round of 16.
Kuftia and Lake.
Okay, Constable and Lake. Constable and Lake, and that will be on line 20. All right, line 22. This will be to play Mara and Dan Trefoy in the round of 16 as the third seeded team.
Angel and Chirpinski.
Angelus and Chirpinski. Kevin Angelus and Ariana Chirpinski. All right, line 25 and 26. Another pigtail. Gio, go ahead, buddy.
Schrader and Guerrero.
Schrader and Guerrero. Zachary Schrader and Hanley Guerrero on line number 25. And here we go. We have three more to go.
Sanchez and Sanchez.
Okay, the next team is Sanchez and Sanchez.
And then Alessandra and Kerman.
Okay, and the last team here is Joe Alessandrini and Julie Carmen. I believe, Ralph, this actually will go on line number 30. It will go down and will go on line number 30.
This one goes on 30?
Correct. Yep. Alessandrini and Carmen go on 30. And then Sanchez goes on line 28 then. And then the bye is Guerrero and Schrader.
Hold on a second.
Okay, and then so line 26 would be a bye, yep.
Well, you've got the bye goes on the top, so.
Okay, so again, looking at the mixed doubles, four-seeded teams, it is a 32 draw. Gio, Juliet, thank you very much. You guys can have a seat. Great job tonight, help picking our draws for mixed doubles, men's doubles, and the 18s mixed doubles as well. We'll just give Ralph a second here to fix the draw here. And there we go. Okay, moving on here. Now we're going to get into some of the smaller draws. We've done most of the bigger ones here at the beginning of the show. Next is men's 35 and over singles. And if we look at our men's 35 and over singles, we have two seeds. We have AJ Garabedian and number two seed David Jemison down at the bottom. So if we go all the way back to the top, Ralph, we'll look there. So this will be on line three. We have Doug Taylor from Wilkes-Barre taking on William Neal from Schnecksville. And also on the bottom half of the draw, we have, or on the top part, the bottom half of the top part, we have Chris Schrader from Rennie taking on Mark Marone from Wyomissing. On the bottom half of the draw, we have Joe Bonner taking on Sanchez Buenaventura with the winner to get Joe Alessandrini, the head coach of the Twin Valley Raiders. On lines 13 and 14, we have Bumpadre. We have Adam Bumpadre against Carl Oberholzer with the winner to get the number two seed, Dr. Dave Jemison. All right, men's 45 and over doubles, and we will be transitioning here to another senior draw, and this draw has two seeded teams. We have the top seeded teams, multiple time hits pro 45 and over champions, Doug White and Don Hutchinson, and the two seeds, Brian Miller and Steve Simons. If we look at this draw in the quarterfinals, Hutchinson and White will have a bye. Friel and Keaton from Philadelphia, they will play Bruder and Phil Ponerance, okay? Hard to read that spelling. And then on the bottom, we have Bill Garasu and...
It's Garceau.
Garceau and Sven Spearing. And they will be taking on the team of Frank Farfan and Brian Rothermel with the winner to get Miller and Simons. All right, Ralph, we're going to head over to do some of our family draws now. We're going to continue through the family draws before we wrap things up with some more junior draws at the end. Okay, our father-son doubles. If we want to go to that draw, Ralph, we have...
There's nothing there.
Okay, father-son, looks like a little technical difficulty here with the father-son. We will just go ahead and skip that draw and then generate that one after the show. And then again, all these draws will be on itsforhope.com once all the schedules are up this coming weekend. I will say the two teams are Garabedian, and the team of Jeremy and Chance Loomis, the coach down at Swarthmore. There's the top two seeds, and again, we will generate that draw. Looks like a computer issue with TDM, so we'll get that generated here very shortly and continue through the rest of the draws here. Next, we have the father-daughter doubles, and we have six teams here. Our top seeds, Phil and Emma Perkins, and our two seed, we have Frianna Farfan and her dad, Frank Farfan. If we look at the top half of the draw, we have the Kundurus on line three playing the Del Almos in an all-Exeter matchup. And on line number five, we have Lydia Dayshore and Jeremy Dayshore taking on Mark and Victoria Waltz with the winner to get the Farfans. Okay, Ralph, we have, and the next one we have is just a round robin. It is the mother-son doubles. We can click on that, mother-son doubles. Actually, it is not a round robin. It is four teams.
Yes.
We have the top seed, Iris and Cooper Lehman from Hempfield area. And they will be taking on the Shkreli's, Rocco and Eldane. And on the bottom half, we have Lance and Jody Wilson, and they will be taking on Charlie Robbins and his mom, Noelle. So that'll be the semis and the finals. And again, all the family draws, with the exception of the father-son due to its size, all of them are fast four scoring. Okay, next draw we have is our mother-daughter doubles, and we have four teams for this, including the defending champion here, Kara and Carol Worth, taking on the Holliners in the first round. On the bottom half of the draw, we have Iris and Grace Lehman taking on the Dunwoodies from Westchester. Again, a semi and a final, both rounds, fast four scoring. All right, brother-sister doubles, another unique draw that we've added a few years ago. And this is one of the larger family draws that we have here, brother-sister doubles. Oh, that's brother-brother, Ralph.
Sorry.
Brother-sister doubles. And we have two teams seated here. We have the team of Cooper and Grace Lehman, the sister-brother team, and the two seeds, Victoria and Alex Waltz. Up at the top part of the draw, we have the Lehman's taking on the Sanchez's first round. Leah and Jared Bouchard taking on the McGonagall's, Ty and Emily. We have Seshri Muparju and Siddharth Muparju taking on Nathan and Caroline Berger. And then we have the Kundurus, and they will be taking on the Waltzes as the number two seed here in the brother-sister draw. Okay, next up, brother-brother draw. And if we look at the brother-brother draw, we have seven teams in here. We have two seeded teams. We have the top seeded team of Justin and Michael Schutz, and the second seeded team of Viraj and Vikrant Patel. On line number three, we will have Brian and Jack and the Fitzpatrick brothers, and they will be taking on Matthew and Andrew Borky. And on the bottom half, we have Mark and Eric Yezembowski, and they will be taking on Trent and Aaron McBride, with J.R. Yenser and Derek Yenser taking on the two seeds, Vikran and Viraj Patel. Okay, sister-sister doubles. Now this is a round robin. We have three teams here, Haley and Haley Guerrero, we have Juliet and Emma Perkins, and we have the third team of Catherine and Ashley Ratana. Caitlin and Ashley Ratana. So we have Guerreros, Ratanas, and the Perkins. Okay, and the last draw here, this one is not generated, Ralph, because we are trying to get a fourth team here, the husband and wife doubles draw, so we can wait on that one. We are still waiting for that one to be generated to go through, to hopefully get a fourth team so we don't have to play a round robin. All right, back to some of our junior draws. We're gonna go to the boys 12 and under singles. Boys 12 and under singles. All right, we have one seeded player here. We have five players overall. It is Braden Garcia from Lancaster, and he's the top overall seed. We're making our way down. We have Ty McGonigal, and he'll be taking on Alvaro Sanchez from Reading. And then we have John Thorpe from Conrad Weiser taking on Aaron McBride from Elizabethtown. Boys 12 and under doubles. This is another round robin. Boys 12 and under doubles. Two of the teams. We have Reese Wilson and Aaron McBride, Ty McGonigal, and John Thorpe. And our third team is Christopher Uzar and Braylon Garcia. Braylon Garcia and Chris Uzar are our third team there. Okay, 12 and under mixed doubles. 12 and under mixed doubles. Right above that, Ralph, keep going up. 12 and under mixed doubles. It is another round robin. We have Haley Ortega and Alvaro Sanchez against the McBrides, Janet and Aaron. And our third team for the 12 and under mixed doubles is none other than Juliet Perkins and John Thorpe. Okay, 12 and under girls singles. We have a four player draw here for girls 12 and under singles. And our top seed in the house tonight here as well, just did some picking of the draws, Juliet Perkins. And she will be playing Haley Ortega with Erica Dunwoody and Jan McBride in the other part of the draw. Okay, the next draw. Now this is our first draw of the tournament, and that is our 10 and under co-ed singles. And just to explain this so everybody knows, our 10 and under co-ed singles, that draw is played on a 36 foot court with a red ball, red transition ball on the drop net, so they play across. The scoring will be 2 out of 3 sets to 10 points. Scored 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on. First to 10, that's a set. You win 2 sets in a row. You win if you split sets, you go to 3 sets. Also, serving for our Hits for Hope 10 and under singles is underhand bounce hit. We will be doing underhand bounce hit, no overhand serves for 10 and under co-ed singles. And in this draw, the other thing is we do not have seeds for the 10 and under co-ed singles. It is randomly computer generated. There are no seeds for 10 and under. So we have Natalie Nelson from Sinking Spring taking on Little Philip Perkins, and that'll be in the first round. We have Samantha Edney from Bedford, PA making the trip in, and she'll be playing Olivia Bonita. Next, we have Andrew Pham. He'll be taking on Dylan Chan. And Alvaro Sanchez taking on Isabella Chafin. If we make our way down, is that it, Ralph? I believe that is the whole draw. All 8 players there in the 10 and under co-ed singles, kicking things off Monday at 6 p.m. Okay, our next draw. And the next draw, we will not, there is no draw for this. It is a round robin. And that is the coach player high school doubles. We have those teams already there. And again, not generated in the computer because this is not a fast four scoring or regular scoring. We are playing round robin 10-point tiebreakers. Okay? Round robin 10-point tiebreakers. Okay. The next draw is our, and this is a unique draw to Hits for Hope, our Conrad Weiser alumni men's singles. And this one, Ralph, is listed under the NCRP right there in the computer. And our top seed for the alumni singles. And again, this draw is played on Sunday the 20th, and it is all fast four matches the whole way down. And we have our top seed, Ethan Moyer. He'll be taking on the winner of Alex Waltz and Brian Fitzpatrick. And on the bottom half, we have the other Fitzpatrick, Jack Fitzpatrick, taking on Marquez Zimbowski, with the winner to get the 2 seed, Jaden Lewis. And 3 of those guys in there, recent graduates or will be graduating here this week from Conrad Weiser, so they are allowed to play in the alumni singles.
And that's on the 20th, right?
That is on the 20th.
First day of summer.
The first day of summer, correct. Okay, just a few more draws here to go. And again, there are a few draws that unfortunately are not running, that we just don't have enough teams for or entrants for. And those draws are the boys 14 and under doubles, the mixed 14 and under doubles, and the girls 12 doubles. Those three draws will not be running, just to clarify, so you're not looking for girls 12 and under doubles, mixed 14s, or boys 14s doubles. Those draws will not be running. Okay, our last two draws then here tonight, we have the boys 14 and under singles. This draw is a 16 draw, I believe. And our top seed for that is Austin Kohler. And our number two seed, if we make our way down, is Armand Malik. So Austin Kohler as the top seed, Austin Kohler as the top seed, Armand Malik as the two seed. Okay, if we look at the draw, Austin Kohler will be taking on Kevin Vu in the first round in the quarterfinals. Eric Yazimowski on line five will be taking on Aaron McBride or Ty McGonigal, the winner of that pigtail match. Okay, we have Xavier Motley taking on John Thorpe with the winner to get Mr. Gio Garcia right there on line 12. And on line number 14, we have Blaise Bompadre from Douglasville, and he will be playing the number two seed, Armand Malik. Okay, our last draw that we're going to do here tonight is our girls 14 and under singles. So if we look at girls 14 and under singles, we have one seed, and that is Annika Suresh from Collegeville. She will be the top overall seed for the girls 14 and under singles. Line number three, Reagan Wenrick taking on Janet McBride, and then Hansika Kunduru taking on Juliet Perkins on line number seven and eight in the semifinal round. So with that, that is all the draws here tonight. Ralph, great job getting all those in. It's a yeoman's effort to be able to do that. If you guys want to come back up here, we can wrap things up. And again, we really appreciate everybody watching the draw ceremony here tonight, taking the time to, again, continue to play for something bigger than just yourself, which has been the motto of Hits for Hope for it's 11 years, our 10th tournament. Again, unfortunately, we didn't have the 2020 event due to the COVID-19 pandemic. But I can tell you what, we have been announcing it here. We didn't announce it earlier, but we have 216 players signed up for this tournament. Again, as the largest tennis tournament in Pennsylvania, continuing with 36 draws, we couldn't be more excited here with Conrad Weiser Tennis Association to put this event on, to also have the Berks County Tennis Association involved with our Night of Champions on the 19th of June. It's going to be a great week of tennis, a great festival-like atmosphere of tennis, and we couldn't be more excited to bring it to you here. Ralph, you have any closing thoughts?
Yeah, just one. I know people are going to ask this question, so I figure I'll ask you. Are you going to announce the charity that gets the most donations?
We will. We will be doing that on Saturday night, June 19th at the Night of Champions. Going through the draw or the charities that people have already done through online registrations, we already have all nine charities people have donated to all nine already. So everybody, all the charities will be donated to, which is fantastic. And yes, we will be tallying those up and announcing those totals at the Night of Champions. Just a reminder to everybody, please check the website, www.hitsforhope.com, for all the updates for the tournament. The draws will be on there. Also, checking all the draws, CW stands for Conrad Weiser, Tulpi is Telpa Hocken, and Elko is right on the draw as Elko. They all will be specified. Please make sure you're looking at all your draws and also all the locations where you are playing so everybody can understand where that is and when that is occurring. Okay. We also have a few indoor rain backup areas. We have the two indoor courts here at Conrad Weiser on the wood. We have the Sinking Spring Family YMCA, and we have Hillcrest Racquet Club as well, about 35 minutes away if we do have inclement weather. Please, throughout the week, check your emails. Email, unless you hear something, everything is on as scheduled, unless you are emailed about it. We also have our Twitter, hits_for_hope, Hits for Hope on Twitter. Find us on there. That will have live updates as well. If there are any major delays, rain, things like that, you can hop on the Twitter, which is also connected to the website. So again, everything's going to kick off next Monday with the 10 and under tournament on June 14th. The juniors will be in action the 15th, 16th, and 17th. Family draws the night of the 15th, 16th, and 17th. And the adults playing 17th, 18th, 19th, and 20th of June. So again, we couldn't be more excited here from Hits for Hope to be able to bring the tournament here, the largest tennis tournament in Pennsylvania, to you.
On the East Coast.
On the East Coast. Third biggest on the East Coast. Thank you, Ralph. So, again, we want to thank our helpers here tonight, our junior players, Gio Garcia and Juliet Perkins, for helping us with the draw ceremony. Our tournament referee, Ralph Tutling, for going through and doing all the hard work on the TDM platform. So, for everyone here at Hits for Hope, I'm your tournament director, Ryan Knarr, and we will see you guys on the courts next week for Hits for Hope 2021. Have a great night.
It's here.